Then I'll get for the second derivative of y respect to x, I'll have to put du by dx. And then plus 3dy by dx will be 3u, because dy by dx is now written as u. Minus 5, first derivative of z respect to x is w. Plus 11y minus 7z is equal to 0. Not equal to 0, is equal to e to the power minus x. That's what's given to me. So you can already see that by making these substitutions, I don't have any second derivative terms now. I have only first derivative terms. Same thing I'll do to the second differential equation, which is 13 and second derivative of z respect to x. That'll become first derivative of w respect to x. Minus 29, I have first derivative of y respect to x. That'll become u. Plus 31, first derivative of z respect to x. That'll become w. Minus 37y. Plus 41z, these are the rest of the terms which are as is equal to sine of x. So again, what you're finding out is that you have all these terms which are written there. So this becomes my, this is my equation number 3, and this is my equation number 4, which I have here. So let's go ahead and see that now how I can write down these four differential equations which I have written. So what I've done is that I already, let me go back here. I already shown that I've written my dy by dx. Here, let me just focus on these two equations here. So I already shown that dy by dx is equal to u and dz by dx is equal to w. So as I said, that this will be my one first order differential equation. This will be another first order differential equation. Then I reduce the main two ones which were given to me to first order differential equations. So that gives me four first order ordinary differential equations. So since it gives me four first-order differential equations, that means that now I have four simultaneous first-order ordinary differential equations. And now I can use the methods which I have learned for my numerical methods of solving ordinary differential equations to do that. So I'm going to rewrite my equations now. So my first equation, which was dy by dx equal to u. So my first differential equation is dy by dx equal to u. And this is my first differential equation for which I need an initial condition. And the initial condition will be needed on y. So that'll be y sub 0, which is equal to 13, which is given to me. And that becomes my first equation. Now, if I look at the second equation, is dz by dx is equal to w. And now I'll need the initial condition on the value of z. And z of 0 is already given to me as 19. And that becomes my second differential equation. So you see how I'm setting these up. Now, the third differential equation is going to come from here. So let me go back here and focus on these two equations here. So what you're going to find out is that you're going to get a differential equation in terms of u. So you're going to take everything which you have here to the right-hand side, and also divided by 2. And same thing here, you're going to take everything which is here to the right-hand side and divide by 13 to set up the equation number 4. So that's how this is going to pan out. So let me write this down now. So I get du by dx is my third differential equation. It will be equal to e to the power minus x minus 3u plus 5w minus 11y plus 7z. Divided by 2. And I'll need a corresponding initial condition on u. Now you got to understand that u is nothing but dy by dx. So that means that I will need the condition on whatever the dy by dx is given to me. So I need u sub 0. U sub 0 is nothing but dy by dx at 0. And that value is turning out to be 17. Okay. And that's my third differential equation. Same thing, my last differential equation which I will need will be dw, written in terms of dw by dx, and that will turn out to be sine of x plus 29u minus 31w plus 37y minus 41z divided by 13. And again, the initial condition which I will need is on w. But w is not my original variable. W of naught, I will need the initial condition. But w naught is nothing but dz by dx at 0. And that value here is 23. And that gives me equation number 4. So what I have now is that if I go here all the way from the first one, I have this first differential equation, and this will be my first function f sub 1, which will be given in terms of x, y, z, u, and w. Although it's u is the only term, but it's actually the function of the independent variable and the two dependent variables and the two which I introduced here. This is the second differential equation. This will become the function f sub 2, again a function of x, y, z, u, and w. The independent variable, the two dependent variables, and the two which I introduced. And here will be function f sub 3 now, which will be a function of x, y, z, u, and w. And here you are seeing instances of all of those in the expression there. And this one here will be the function f sub 4, x come of, and the arguments being x, y, z, u, and w. So now you have been able to set it up in the form which will allow you to solve them by using your numerical methods for solving ODEs. And that's the end of this segment.